If I say good habits, a lot of people think like meditation, eat healthy food and don't drink like cola and Red Bull and stuff like this, right? So everyone knows what like good habits are, but obviously this video would be boring if I tell only those. So in this video, I wanna like contain 5 good habits that you can use in CS, but it's also like outside CS that you can benefit from. And as well as one which is kind of like a stereotype good habit, but it's really needed to introduce in this video. And with that said, I would like to start with the first point, and that's exercise. So exercise is the one only stereotype good habit in this video that I will introduce, because it gives you better mood, better mindset, and overall just like in general, you enjoy more life, you're more positive about things, and it changes your mentality a lot. So having good physique and basically exercise, being disciplined in those things is really crucial to becoming professional or to become whatever you want, right? Second point, we have system in utility. So this is a little bit concrete, it's in CS, but I think if you're playing like whatever other esport game you're playing, it's also like you can apply for that as well. But in CS is basically system in utility. What that means is that I see a lot of people don't remember their utility, like literally. They maybe go on offline server once per month and just like throw some basic utility, but they're not watching this like extra content that YouTube can provide. Like for example, now around here, Austin CS or Smirky. And there is like couple more, like you have so many content creators, like for example me, that is also providing for you some knowledge about utility and stuff. So you can just watch them on daily basis, learn for them. But the most important thing is that have a system in the utility. So as you can see on the screen, I have basically folder, which means that I am always placing, like I record through OBS some utility, and basically I name it like, let's say Motor Smoke, okay? And I put it in Inferno folder. And what I basically do is that before the match, okay, let's say I'm playing Faceit, I'm playing Inferno, so before I'll look to the folder, what utility I'll just like quickly say to them, so I know what that means, right? I save them by myself. So basically Motor Smoke, okay, I know I should do this. So basically I have, let's say, 6 videos or something, and then after the match I will go again to this folder and I will tell myself why I didn't use this utility. If I did, was it good? Should need some changes, stuff like this. And this will so much, you will so much get a progress. If you are lazy to do that, I understand it's kind of like a work plus, you want to only focus on Faceit, not only like on utility, stuff like this. What is really important is just to save them, and let's say once per month you will recap every map with every utility, new one that you basically learn. So I think this system helps me a lot, but I know there is also like a website where you can like save the utility itself and stuff like this. So it's up to what system will you choose. Third point is learn other positions, especially if you're playing pucks. So I know this kind of like annoys people, because a lot of people aren't that type that would like watch demos on daily basis, stuff like this, but this is really important. If you're playing pucks especially, but if you're also in team environment, this is really helpful as well. So basically, let's say map, as an example, let's say Vertigo on CT side. If you will learn the concept, how he's playing on mid, you don't need to know like off angles, insane position, insane utility, but at least like the basic positions and the concept about the position. So let's say mid CT. Mid as a CT, you need to delay, like let's say first 10 seconds. That means you're going, you're throwing the molly off the wall so it will bounce up, and you're buying 10 seconds for rotations to come in, and then you are basically playing some setup on mid, right? So you're basically buying time for your rotation to support teammates while rotations is rotating to mid, and mid player can play with rotations on certain setup. So that's the goal of mid player. And if you're a T-side player, and that's also with the team environment stuff, if you will learn every position, like concept of angle stuff like this first, you know their position, so you probably like will have more percentage to kill them because you know the off angle stuff like this. But the most important thing is that you know the concept. So if mid player is throwing molly on the wall every round, you know that he's delaying time for the rotations. So you can abuse it. How? I don't know, it's up to you. Like, you can smoke the money, you can rush in, you can just kill him because he's not ready for that. And then you have mid and you know that rotation is going to elevator because they're playing like this, right? They can play different, they can start two mid. They're starting two mid most of the times, they will not throw the money. So it really depends, it's most likely depends on what level are you playing. And that's the most important thing. But you can read a lot of enemies like this. And the most important thing is in pucks. If you are playing pucks, you need to know at least two positions on CT. I know a lot of people saying like, I play window or I drop, you know, like this classic answer. And this guy just can't play anything else. For example, Mirage, I can play con, I can play window, I can play BS. So three positions is enough. But also if you want to learn other positions, then go for it, right? It's really good to be filled position because you can swap around. If somebody's really bad on this position, you can swap with him. And I think knowing more positions than one is really beneficial. Fourth point is consistent routine. And I'm not talking about only aim routine, like going on deathmatch, then going on bots and you're ready. But I'm also talking about like physical routine, let's say, if I can call like this, which means that stretching hands, like let's say this, because obviously you have carpal tunnels. If you want to become pro, whatever, if you want to be graphic in future, if you want to be whatever on PC you are doing, and you will fuck carpal tunnels, then your life is fucked. So basically, as I said, it's really important to have some physical routine as well. But to the aim routine, which is the most important part, try to basically build up by your own, because everyone is different, and if you will enjoy the routine, that's the most important thing. You need to know what time you need for you to warm up. Someone can just hop on face it and give like 30 frags like Saibu or Dong, or someone can like literally need like 1 hour of warm up like me, because if I don't have 1 hour of warm up, then I'm playing so bad. So you need to know it, like you need to know when you're feeling it, and noting down those things to basically like know yourself, and then build up a routine based on it, right? And do the warm-up routine every day. And I mean, if it's only that much, still you will improve by, let's say, 1 month, like you will see the progress really well. So stay disciplined and focus on one routine, that's really important. And last point that everyone was waiting for is touch of grass.